Good day, students. Today I am going to teach you about grammar topic, about changing the voice. There are two types of voice, active and passive voice. Now, as you know, a sentence is a group of words which are arranged in a proper grammatical order which conveys a proper meaning. If we divide a sentence, it could be divided into basically into two parts, the subject and the predicate. The predicate begins with the verb. So if we are changing the voice in terms of voice, a sentence we are dividing into three parts, which is a subject, verb and a object. Now, which sentences can be changed into active voice and which sentences can be changed into passive voice? For this, let us see what is active voice and what is passive voice, because all the sentences you cannot change into passive voice. Now, active voice. What is active voice? When the subject is the doer of the action, the subject placed in the sentence is doing the action, then the sentence is said to be in active voice. Whereas its opposite, that is passive voice, when the subject in the sentence is the receiver of the action, the subject is receiving the action done by somebody, then that sentence is said to be in passive voice. Now, what is subject? Subject is made up of two words, sub plus ject. What is sub? Sub means, here we take it in general sense, sub means somebody, and ject means do. Do means do any action. That's why subject is formed of sub plus ject, means when somebody does the action, it is said to be in active voice. Whereas another part of the sentence, which is usually towards the end, which is usually after the verb, which is called object. So what is object? Ob plus ject. Ob means effect. Another synonym for ob, ob means the effect is received. The action is received. Here again, ject means do or action. When an object receives, the effect is received by the action done by the doer, then it is called the passive voice. So, subject and object are the parts of the sentence which are very important when you change any voice. Now, see here one example I have written. The hunter killed a tiger. The hunter is the subject because the hunter is doing the action of killing. So, what is killing? Any action is called a verb. In parts of speech, if you see, what is an action? Action words are called verbs. So, the hunter killed a tiger. Now, tiger is placed towards the end in the sentence. It is the receiver of the action. What is the action done here? Killed. Who is doing the action? The hunter. So, hunter killed a tiger. Tiger is the receiver of the action. So, tiger is an object here. Now, we concentrate on the verb. A sentence cannot be formed without a verb. Yes, sentence cannot have an object. Then also it can be a sentence. But for a sentence, verb is must. So, when you come to this step, the first thing, you divide the sentence into three parts. You identify the subject, the doer of the action. Then the second is, you have to identify the verb, underline the verb. And the third part, who is the receiver of the action, that is object. Now, verb is very important. As a verb is divided into two parts, transitive for active and passive voice, transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. Now, for changing any voice, a verb should be transitive. What does transitive means? Transits means affects the action. The verb which affects an action, it means it is affecting the question. Here, I have written the verb killed. Killed is affecting what? This action of killing is done on whom? The tiger. That's why this verb is transitive verb. Why it is transitive verb? Because it is affecting the object. It is affecting the object. The effect is done on someone. That's why it is called transitive verb. Whereas its opposite is intransitive verb. Intransitive verb does not affect any action. Though verb is there, but it is not showing any action. Another thing I want to see the sentence I have written here. She writes a letter. What is the verb here? Which action is showed here? Writes. Who writes the letter? She. So, she is the subject. writes its the verb. She writes what? The writing action is performed on what? A letter. So this is a transitive verb. Whereas in intransitive, you see, he goes to school. He goes. It does not affect school. Another thing I want to explain you is, if you want to find out whether the verb is transitive or intransitive, a simple trick I am showing you, you have to ask the question what after the verb. Only one question you ask, what. If it answers to your question, if you get the answer to your question, what, then that sentence you can change into passive voice. Now see, if I ask here, she writes, what is the verb here? Identify the verb. Writes. What is the subject? She. Now ask the question here. She writes what? You get an answer. A letter. That means this sentence can be changed into passive voice. Now let me explain you in intransitive. Now I have written here, he goes to school. This is also a sentence which conveys a meaning. It also has verb, goes. It also has subject. What is the subject? He. He goes, but question you have to ask is only what. He goes what? Do you get an answer? Here the answer to the question what? No. Your answer we are getting to school, to shows place. It answers to the question where. That means this verb does not affect the action done by the subject. It is intransitive. That means this sentence I cannot change into passive voice. Is that clear? Only verbs which are transitive could be changed into passive voice. Now I'll teach you certain rules to change active voice to passive voice. You will concentrate on this and remember, whenever you try to change any voice, you have to keep in mind these rules. The sentence depends usually on the tense of the verb. Tense of the verb is very important in a sentence. Now see, the first one I have taken, there are three tenses: present tense, past tense and future tense. So first we'll start with present tense. In present tense, simple present tense. Simple present tense will have three helping verbs: am, is and are. So if your verb is in simple present tense, then when you are changing into passive voice, you have to add by, by, and past participle of the verb. What is past participle of the verb? It is the third form of verb. Like if you have the word, suppose here the verb is given drink. Drink is simple present tense. Past tense will be drank and past participle will be drunk. Now see one example I have written. I drink milk every day. Now first thing, we identify the verb in a sentence. What is the action here? Drink. So drink is the verb. Who drinks? Who is the doer of the action? That is the subject. What is the subject here? I. So I is the subject because I is shown to be drinking milk. I drink milk. Now ask the question what I told you before. If you want to change any sentence, first thing after the verb, you ask the question what. If you get an answer to your question what, then that sentence you can change it into passive voice. Now I drink what? So you get answers here. There are two words: milk every day. Now here two objects are there. Now see, milk, I drink what? So you have to take the only the main object, that is milk, because every day is adverb of time. Every day you need not change. You don't change the place of every day, everywhere, by. These are adverbs of time. So every day will be placed there. So I drink what? So your object, answer to your object is milk. So milk is the object. So your passive voice will be, start with the what is the object in the sentence, that will become subject in passive voice. So what is our object here in active voice? Milk. So milk. Okay. Now milk, so object is placed in the subject. Now milk is an uncountable noun. Uncountable nouns are usually used only with singulars. So here we cannot use, here it was I. If it is I, then I have to use am, am as helping verb. Here is and are. Is for singular and are is for plural. Now milk is an uncountable noun. For uncountable nouns, you cannot use are. So here we'll use milk is. Now drink will change past participle form of the verb. Drink will change to drunk. Milk is drunk. So milk is drunk. Then you have to add by, by. By plus object. What is the object? I. When I comes in the object, it becomes me. So our subject, verb, object is reversed here. It has become object, verb and subject. So where this everyday will go? Everyday will remain in its place because it is adverb of time. Milk is drunk by me every day. This is your correct passive voice. Now we are taking another sentence. The hunter kills the tiger. Again you concentrate on the verb. What is the verb here? Kills. It has S in the end. This indicates that it is in simple present tense. Now when the verb has S, that means the subject is always singular. So what is the subject here? The kills is the verb and the hunter is the subject. Chalo, ask the question. The hunter kills what? What do you have in the answer? The tiger. So the tiger becomes object. So your sentence now will start with the tiger. Okay, stop. Now concentrate on the verb. Kills. Kills is in which tense? Kills is in simple present tense. When it is simple present tense, see the subject. Subject is singular, the tiger. Right? So you have to use is. Is. The tiger is. Now go to the, again to the, what rule I have taught you. After verb, you write past participle of the verb. Kill will change to killed. The hunter is killed plus by whom? Your subject will become the tiger is killed by the hunter. Now here this I want to, kills has changed to is killed because your subject was, verb was in simple present tense. That's why is written. Same way here, see the next sentence. The hunters kill the tigers. S. Hunters. Tigers. Now see the verb. Kill. It doesn't have S like which we had in the previous sentence. This shows that again kill means it is in present tense, but the subject is, because the verb doesn't have S towards the end, the subject is plural. So kill is the verb. Who kills? Who is doing the action of killing? The hunters. So your hunters are the subject and the hunters, again ask the question. The hunters kill what? You get the answer, the tigers. So the tigers are the object. So your sentence starts with the tigers. Okay, stop. The tigers. The tigers, then verb is kill. Right? The tigers kill. Now see the subject. Singular or plural? We have S here, so tigers shows that they are plural. Plural plus present tense. That means we have to use A-R-E-R. The tigers are past participle of kill. Killed by your subject of active voice will become the tigers are killed by the hunters. So here for simple present tense is, for simple present tense, R for plural form of simple present tense. Now we come to the second tense, that is simple past tense. Simple past tense. Past tense indicates the helping verbs was and were. So you have to remember was slash were plus by plus past participle object plus past participle of the verb. Now past participle of the verb I have written here in short form PPV. So wherever I write PPV, you have to understand that it is past participle, third form of the verb. Now simple past tense. Look at the example. The same sentence I am using. Throughout the topic, I have used only one sentence as example. The hunter kills the tiger with different forms of verbs. Now see here, the hunter killed the tiger. Look at the verb. Killed. Does it have any helping verb ahead? No. So it shows that it is in simple past tense. What is the subject? The hunter. What is the object? The tiger. Now the object becomes the subject. This sentence, can we change this sentence into passive voice? Let's see. The hunter killed what? The tiger. So we have to write here the tiger. Okay, now wait. The tiger killed. Killed is in which tense? Past tense. After identifying the tense, you have to see the subject. Subject is in which form, plural or singular? It is singular. So you will have was. The tiger was killed by the hunter. What I have added, which helping verb I have added? Was, because the subject was singular. Now let's make a slight change. The same sentence I am doing, and I am adding here S. The hunter killed the tigers. So what is my object in the active voice? The tigers. So here I will write the tigers. What is the verb again? Killed. Same as in previous sentence. But look at our subject. From tiger, our subject has changed to tigers. The tigers. So it is in plural form. So instead of was, here it will be the tigers were killed by the hunter. Is that clear? When to use was and when to use where? After identifying the verb, you have to concentrate on the subject. Subject is in which form, singular or plural? Now third tense, that is simple future tense. Future, the things, actions which are going to happen. For there are two helping verbs, will and shall. Whenever you use will or shall, you have to use the helping verb be. B-E-B. It is a helping verb which is very necessary when you use helping verbs will and shall. So will and shall plus be plus by plus object and past participle of the verb. This is the basic form. Again the sentence. The hunter, I have written, will kill the tiger. Why I have added will? Because here I am teaching you the future tense. That's why will indicates that this sentence in future tense. Now what will be my verb now? I can't write underline only ill. Only kill. You always have to include the helping verb also as the verb. So now my verb will be will kill. The hunter will kill the tiger. This action is not done. It is going to happen in future. Now, can this sentence be changed into passive voice? Of course, because it has an object which answers to our question. What? The hunter will kill what? You get the answer, the tiger. Now, what changes you will make? Same. The tiger. Okay, wait. The tiger. Now, see on the verb. Will kill. Will kill is going to perform that action. So with will, you have to add the helping verb be. The tiger will be. Now kill will change to past participle, third form of verb. Will be killed by, again the subject of the active voice, killed by the hunter. So to concentrate on the verb and the forms of the verb and then on the subject. Now fourth is present perfect tense. Perfect tense. Perfect tense have two helping verbs starting. See, usually helping verbs in perfect tense starts with H. That is a hint which I give you. Usually all the helping verbs in perfect tense start with H. So there are two helping verbs, has and have. Has is used for singular subjects. And have is used where there are plural forms of subjects. Now when you use has or have in a sentence, compulsorily you have to use be, double E and been. This indicates perfect tense. Has or have plus be, double E and been. Again, because we are changing into passive voice, so by is must plus then the object and PPV, that is past participle of the verb. Now same sentence I am using, only the form of verb is changed. Look, the hunter has killed the tiger. Look at the verb. Can I identify only as killed? No, I have to include has also because it is helping verb. So my verb in this sentence is has killed. Come on, the hunter has killed what? I get the answer the tiger. That means this sentence I can change into passive voice. Now the tiger is the object. So our sentence starts with object, the tiger. Okay, wait. Now after identifying the tiger, what you have to see? The verb. The verb is has killed. Has indicates perfect tense. When you have has or have in the sentence, you have to use be, double, and been. So that, and the second rule, the subject is singular or plural. I have written the tiger. The tiger is singular or plural. It doesn't have has. We are talking about only one particular tiger. So it will have has, has. The tiger has plus been. Has been, third form of the verb, killed by the hunter. Now see one easy trick I am going to show you, that when we are saying this passive voice, the tiger has been killed by the, you have to exclude cut, been, and by, then your sentence will become into active voice. Here we are adding, here been we added, I added been, and you added by, then it is becoming passive voice. If you want to reverse the action, then you have to exclude been and by. Okay, now we come to the past perfect tense. Past perfect. Past tense means the actions which are already done. So for past tense, there are two helping verbs, had, sorry, your had slash. Past tense, we have only one helping verb, had. And for perfect tense, you have to use the word be, the helping verb be, double, and been. So here the hunter had killed the tiger. Look at the verb had killed. Now here for past perfect tense, it doesn't, you don't have to change either it is singular or plural. Your subject is singular, plural. Your helping verb remains only had. This you have to remember very well. So here the hunter had killed what? The tiger. So the tiger had, plus had plus what you have to add? Been. The tiger had been killed by the hunter. Just concentrate on the verb had been killed. So if your sentence, you have to identify, if your sentence has had, then your passive voice should have had been. For whether the subject is singular or plural, but your helping verb for past perfect tense will remain had only. If I make here tigers, the hunter had killed the tigers. So here my subjects will be the tigers. So now you will tell teacher, your subject is plural. So verb will not change. No, it will not change because it is past perfect tense. Now future perfect tense. Future, again future means actions which are going to happen, shall or will. But and present tense, so it is have plus been. The hunter will have killed the tiger. Will have killed. Still that action is about to complete, it has not been completed. Only will and have will remain same. Because it is perfect tense, you have to add only be, double, and been. So the answer will be the tiger. Again same all three verbs. Will, have, again helping verb, what you have to add? Be, double, and been. Been killed by the hunter. So you have to concentrate on the verb. Will have will change to will have been in future perfect tense. Now perfect tense is over. Now present continuous tense. Continuous, the action which is going now. Right now if I am teaching you grammar, same way continuous tense, how you will identify the verb? The verb will have ing. The verb will have ing in the question. If your sentence has spelling with ing, the verb with ing, that means your sentence is in continuous tense. Now for continuous tense, because it is present continuous, there are three helping verbs, am, is, or are, as we had in present, simple present tense. But because it is continuous, you have to add being, being. So this killing will change the third form into third form of verb and you have to add B-E-I-N-G, being. Now see our sentence. The hunter is killing the tiger. The action is going on. So your verb is killing. Now your question has ing. It shows that it is in continuous tense. So your answer should also have ing. Now ing, but not in the verb. The verb will change to its third form, past participle. Instead of ing, you have to add the word helping verb B-E-I-N-G, be. Now the hunter is killing what? You get the answer, the tiger. Is tense remains same. The tiger is, you have to add B-E-I-N-G, being. The tiger is being. Now kill will change to past participle. Third form of kill is killed. The tiger is killed by the hunter. Now see here. Is killing is changed to is being killed. But ing verb is, word is also here. And ing, this you have to remember. In that in continuous tense, your question and answer both should have an ing verb. This is one trick to remember the continuous tense. Same way, helping verb, if it changes to are, then your sentence, the tigers are being killed by the hunter. Now, past continuous tense, the actions which are already done. For past tense, two helping verbs was and were, and again B-E-I-N-G, being, for continuous tense. The hunter was killing the tiger, was killing. So my verb is was killing. So your answer will be the hunter, again helping verb was, and because it is ing, so I have to add B-E-I-N-G, being. The hunter was being killed by the tiger was being, I wrote here, hunter, I have to write here tiger. The tiger was being, so was killing has changed to was being killed. Was will remain same, killing has changed to past participle killed, and we have added B-E-I-N-G, being. Now, the tenses are over. Now, what about the modal verbs? What are modal verbs? Modal verbs are helping verbs which are used before the verbs to give more meaning. Can, could, may, might, these are called modal verbs, auxiliary verbs. With the modal verbs, when you have can, could, may, might in a sentence, you have to use B-E-B plus object of the sentence and past participle of the verb. Look at the example. The hunter can kill the tiger. Can, it has an ability, the can word shows. Now can will change to, with can you have to add B-E-B. So now I'll write here, if I ask the question, the hunter can kill what? The hunter can kill the tiger. So tiger can be, and kill will change to its third form, killed by the hunter. Same way, if you have could, then could will change to could be. If you have may will change to may be. Now students, when I explained you the transitive verb, I told you that all the sentences you cannot change into passive voice, because those sentences will not have object. Now those sentences means the imperative sentences. What are imperative sentences? Imperative sentences are commands, requests, orders. These are called imperative sentences. Now, orders only in passive voice, it is an exception that you can change orders and request into passive voice. Why it is so? Because imperative sentences do not have subject. See the example I have written here, close the door. The sentence begins with the word close. What is close? Close is a action, it is verb. Does it have a subject here? It does not have a subject. So how can we change this? But it does have an object. You ask the question, close what? You get an answer here, the door. That means this sentence I can change into passive voice. Now what is the object? The door. But when you change an order or request into passive voice, your sentence should begin with let. So your sentence will be let, then the object. What is the object? the door. Let the door. And then you have to use, sorry, you have to use be plus by. Let the door, always with let, you have to use the helping verb be. Let the door be closed by. Because we don't know to whom we are talking, the subject is unknown. So drop the subject. So let the door be closed. See that now this sentence was an order. Close the door. So that is converted into passive voice by adding the word let and helping verb be. Now the interrogative sentences. What are interrogative sentences? The sentence which are in the form of questions. Usually the question sentence begins with five words starting with W. Who, what, which, when, where. And the one is how. Those sentences are interrogative sentences which ends with a question mark. Now what about those sentences? Those sentences also same rules you have to apply. Only the form of the sentence is different. It is interrogative form. See the example. Example I have written, who broke the jug? The sentence begins with a capital letter. It has a verb and it ends with a question mark. That's why it is an interrogative sentence. Same rule you have to apply. Identify the verb. What is the verb here? Broke. What is the subject? Who? Ask the question. Who broke what? You get the answer. The jug. So now the jug becomes the object. Now here you have to concentrate. Who will change to by whom? By whom? Because the subject was who. When it comes into passive voice, it will change to whom. Now broke. Broke is in, already it is in past tense. So it will change into past participle. By whom, and broke is in past tense. Past tense and subject is singular. So was. By whom was the jug broken? This way, following the rules, you can change any given sentence into passive voice and passive into active voice. Concentrate on the subject, object and the verb of the sentence, forms of the verbs of the sentence, and these syntax which I have given for each tense of the verb. Then you can change any form of the sentence. Quickly, I'll just recapitulate. Active and passive voice, all the sentences you cannot change into passive voice, only the verbs which are having transitive verbs, those sentences can be changed into passive voice.